Hey folks, how you doing? I'm Andy, this is Nao Guitar. I teach you songs acoustically so that you can play them without a band. And today it's no exception. We're taking a look at Wicked Game, Chris Isaak. Here is the tab. It's for you. I made it for you. Come and get it. It is in the description and the first comment down below, there to make your life as easy as possible. Interesting song, this one, for putting onto acoustic. As I said, we are trying to take this and put it into a single guitar. Well, I hadn't said that yet, but that is the gist of what I'm all about. Trying to take a band song and squeeze it into the guitar. What are the chords, Andy? I hear you say. They are B minor, A, E. Ah, but I don't like bar chords. They hurt my hand. What do you do? Very simple little easification. There's a new word for you. In other words, making it easier. We take our B bar chord and we don't bar it. We just lift that first finger up. Which fits just dandy. How's that? Made your life easier. Hit the like button. Sounds like a good trade. Our strumming. Down, down, up. Up, down. B minor, A, E, E. You don't need the sheet necessarily for the main part of the song because that is it. You do need it though for the riff that we'll be doing in a moment. So let's have a good little strum of this and just get the feel for the song. This is what we're doing most of the time, not the riff. Everyone thinks about the riff. How can we make that interesting for ourselves and really put the overall vibe of the song into just a single guitar? Well, we can play with those two versions of the B minor that I mentioned, the bar and lifting it up. For the A, you've seen me doing a little bit of action there. You can do your hammer-ons. We're just playing between that third finger on and off. And then E. That is actually part of the riff that's in the song anyway, so we're drawing from what's already there. What am I doing? An E sus 4, adding my fourth finger. That's that little bit in the riff. It on, taking it off. So that gives you a bit to play with for playing through the song. I know you're asking for it. Teach me the riff. All right, I'll teach you the riff. It's a little awkward. You've got to get that bar there to begin with, but you can do it. I know you can. Might just take a bit of work. Getting it flowing is the hard bit. So what's going on there? Let's break it apart piece by piece. Slowly does it. Be a tortoise, not a hare. Start off with our B minor bar chord. I'm going to pick out the A string, E, B, G. Then we lift off the bar. See how those things that I was doing there is actually drawn from this riff? We bar, then we let it off. So we pick those same three strings. So instead of getting 2, 3, 4, we now get 0, 3, 4. From there, things get a little bit kinder. We keep the third and the fourth fingers there from the B minor. And our first finger comes up a string to the B string, second fret. That's a little nicer. First finger off. You gotta squeeze them. So, 2, 4, 4, 0, 4, 4. Similar approach. Finger on, finger off. from there. So still keeping that third finger there. If you're getting some lines on your fingers right now, you're in good company. Trying to make this ring throughout. Then we get some relief. E. Ringing is what it's all about. Especially when we don't have a delay pedal. So we got E. Then we pick out A, G strings. Then we do the same again, but we hammer on to the second fret on the G string. Open B. And then to keep that ringing, we throw the E string and the D string in there. E, A, G are your strings. A, G, hammer, open B, E, D. Or if you think of fret numbers, E chord, 2, 1, 2, 1, hammer, O, O, 2. Woo! Give him a rub. Slowly does it. And you can really, on that E chord, you can pick out the individual strings like we did, or we can lean more that direction that I just did there, where it's more of a strumming approach. And doing this brush stroke, kind of just picking out strings at random, it doesn't matter, it's all part of the E chord. And at the end of the day, the framework for the song is B minor, A, E. This is something I've noticed over the years that students really have trouble wrestling with when I give them that freedom to go, it doesn't have to be note for note. People get really caught up in note for note. And even when they do get a song down note for note, if their baseline skills aren't there, it still sounds a mess anyway. The important thing is that you've got the feel, and that in a song like this especially, you've got to keep those notes ringing out. That's the stuff that's important. Not that you hit the exact right string at the right time perfectly to the tab, because you can still botch it and make it sound terrible. So I'm giving you permission right now as the mayor of guitar internet land to focus on the groove and the feel. As long as you're holding that E chord, you can hit whatever strings you like. There's the original. Just did like four or five different variations there. See how they all fit? As long as we got the E, sus for E, you're peachy. There it is for you. If you don't have the tab yet, go and grab it now. It's absolutely free in the description down below or the first comment. My name's Andy. Sling me a like for doing the good karma thing for you. And of course, be sure to subscribe so you don't catch future lessons here on the channel. If you want to learn songs quickly, what's the smartest way to do that? Learn easy songs. I have a thing called the Easy Songs Cheat Sheet. It is a list of easy songs for you to learn quickly so you can get a repertoire together nice and quick, whether it's performing to a bunch of strangers on stage, to thousands of people, maybe hundreds of people, maybe just 10 people in your house, maybe just playing to your partner or a friend, or maybe just playing to your pet. Whatever is the case, music is all about sharing, and I want you to do that. And the best way to make that happen is to learn some easy songs, get them down nice and quick, build momentum with the Easy Songs Cheat Sheet. Grab it now, I'll tell you how. Save countless hours searching for easy songs to learn and download my Easy Songs Cheat Sheet. Click the link in the description now to get it absolutely free.